Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to the Silent Age. We are at the final chapter of the game. It is called Chapter 10, Moebius Strip, which is again a play on words on the Moebius Strip, a geometrical pattern, or rather a shape in which it has no end or beginning. It's sort of like a continuous infinite loop. Yeah, you can make it yourself. I explained how to in the last and outro of the last chapter as well, but just to tell you guys again how to make it, you take a strip of paper, you twist it once, and then you tape the ends back together, and boom, you've got a Moebius strip. So, yeah. Chapter 10, Moebius strip. What a mess. Having narrowly avoided encountering his other self, Joe finds that the time machine is gone. With Dr. Lambert's help, Joe is put in pursuit of the time pilot. But where and when is this place? Good question. Let's see. I mean, the last chapter was left at the start of a cliffhanger. This will reveal all answers forever.
Oh my. What happened?
The only explanation is we probably came to some place in the distant future.
No.
My time machine, it's blown to bits. The consoles are all broken. Terminals sunk halfway into the ground. Yeah, this is distant future, isn't it? This time machine looks pretty banged up, but pretty sure we could actually use it. Should be useful for our journey back, I suppose. But at the same time, we would also be exposed to the virus at this point here. There's a generator, but there's also water dripping down here, and it's entirely flooded this area. There's also a lamp here.
Arr.
I can't reach it, and I can't see any switch. The power generator, I would not like to turn it on right now. It's cold. Why is it the water in the future is always cold? Shall we try turning it on, I guess? It looks like a power generator, but it doesn't turn on. It's a half-buried door, and there's a window, I mean. I wonder what... There's a lot of dirt and rubble in the way. And is there anything else? There's of course a window through which he could probably peek. I can't see a thing through this, of course. That would be too easy, wouldn't it? Damn, that's classy. Oh, I love this. I love this. Spherical contraption, the time machine, I suppose. Wow, is this another time machine? It looks totally different, besides the fact that it's completely falling apart, I mean. I must have been here for quite a while. Dusty metallic surface shovel. Hey, a shovel. I could not read the rest, but I think this might just help us get the door out of the way. I don't really know what it is. It looks like some kind of really impractical kitchen table. It says Berman Solar on it, so solar powered, huh? I can't seem to figure out how this works. Anything else over there? Wait, there is something else over here. Thick roots. And there seems to be a fire burning on the inside. I'm not unhappy with my baseline, but there's no way I'm squeezing through there. Yeah, we need to find something to cut the roots then. And something to shine the light on this. Maybe a UV lamp, like a black UV lamp. Let's use a shovel on the half-buried door. There, all clear. Person in a hazmat suit and a rock here. this block of concrete. The surface is slightly round to the touch. A first aid kit in case this guy needs it. Other than a piece of cloth, this first aid kit has been picked clean. Sorry about that, there was this really noisy vehicle passing through. I could probably find some use for this cloth. And this person in a hazmat suit. Oh, God! He's wearing the same suit I saw in those photos on the wall back at the lab. Must be the time-traveling genius, then. This must be one of those time pilots Dr. Lambert told me about. The ones that never made it back. He's wearing the same suit I saw in those photos on the cryotube. I think it's one of those cryotubes, but this place looks hundreds of years old, maybe more. What year did I end up in? Good question. Can I do something with that? It's a block of concrete, what's it got to look good for? Maybe we could shine the windows? Why mess up a perfectly good drag? I already know what's outside. Oh, so from the outside then. Yeah, I already know what's inside. Good, good. The game actually uses different dialogues for different things. Maybe we could brush the dirt off this panel. Like, wipe the dirt off this panel. It's not making much of a difference. It's still really dirty. So basically, we need something else. I mean, there are these roots here that we can get past. So the solution to these puzzles very obviously lies in the timeline itself, because there's really no other place that we can go. Like, we can't even access the cryotubes and whatnot in this here room. Like, we can't go past this place. This is it, this is the max that we can travel. We could try, like, dipping it in the water and seeing if that helps. I doubt it would, but I suppose that's the only thing left to do at this point. The cloth is not soaking wet, of course it is. Now we use the cloth with the dusty metallic surface. Are we going to do it? They're all clear. Wait, something happened. Oh, I get it. It's a big solar thing. Like on my time machine. It seems to be running now. I wonder what it's powering. The other generator inside. That's what it's powering. At least the lamp that's inside there. And we have started to cough. That's a bad sign. It means we have already contracted the virus there. Here's to hoping that we do not electrocute ourselves. Oh shit. Yes, it turned on. Oh, wow! What is that in the wall? Probably a time traveler who put the input coordinates wrong. What on earth? How is that even possible? Wait, there's something sticking out of his backpack. Looks like a rusty machete. Alright. Rusty machete it is then. That's how we get through the roots. Don't tell me we need to sharpen it first. I couldn't cut paper with these things. With this thing. I'll need something sharper to cut through these roots, I see. That's why the rock is there. The rock with the smooth surface, apparently. I like that little effect in the blue area there. A really neat touch.
Wow.
That's a sharp machete. Look at that. The machete is much sharper now. That block really did the trick. I'm guessing I could not read that part. Shoot, the machete broke. I guess it was rustier than I thought. Oh well, at least I cleared myself the way through. Now to check out what's here. Frank. How are you in the future, Frank? The humidity in the air and the heat from the fire is making everything a little heavy in here. So basically, Frank stole the time machine to get to the future. Are you a janitor or are you a time pilot, is what I would like to know.
Frank?
Joe! Oh, please, need water.
What are you?
Please!
I'll get you some water. Hang in there.
Don't die on me, Frank. I need answers. Pretty sure he's gonna die because this is a pretty long journey. Back and forth, so. Yeah, I really love this touch. The silhouette there. The cup is full. Let's hope that it does not spill over with all that running. Are you still alive, Frank?
Here you go, Frank.
Yes, he is.
Oh, thank you.
I don't understand. What are you doing here? Where are we?
I'm not sure. I had no time. I pushed it as far as it'd go. But from what I've been reading, everything gets imprecise the farther you travel. Even your physical location can get messed up. Nobody's been this far. We could be hundreds, maybe thousands of years in the future for all I know.
I don't get it. So you're a time pilot now?
Do I really need to spell it out for you, Joe? I stole it.
What? You stole the time machine, but why?
Look, I've got no reason to tell you, but I guess it doesn't matter. You're the last person I'll be sharing anything with anyway. The truth is, I'm a Soviet agent.
Cut it out, Frank. I'm not falling for that one again.
I'm not joking.
Frank, you're just sick, confused. Come on, you can't be. Where's your Russian accent?
Joe, I'm an undercover agent deployed by the Kremlin. My job is to fit in. How far do you think I'd get if I went around calling everyone comrade?
Another flashback, huh?
My real name is Yuri Barishev. I came to America in my early 20s. I went to school here, worked here, spent nearly 10 years building the foundation of an ordinary life. But the truth is that my life is far from ordinary. I am a spy. I was planted by the Soviet Foreign Intelligence Agency to gather intel on advanced U.S. military research programs. And I started getting my first missions in the mid-60s. At the time, I thought I had built a promising portfolio of leads. But as I started to pursue them, most of them turned out to be worthless. By 1968, I had run out of goodwill with my handlers at the Kremlin. I was a disgrace, and headed for extraction. desperate for something, anything to report. I came across a Canadian company moving large shipments of iridium, osmium, rare metals not typically used in mainstream manufacturing. The buyer turned out to be a government shell, rerouting the materials to unofficial contractors, one of which turned out to be Archon. Having convinced my superiors that I was onto something, I got a job as a janitor. But I didn't dig up much until you showed up. You were a great distraction, giving me plenty of chances to access off-limits areas. And for a while, I was able to scrounge together enough intel to keep the Kremlin happy. Was correct, but I didn't have the full picture. Not yet. The metals were being used to build something unusual, all right. But I just couldn't piece it together. What I found made no sense. Time travel, doomsday scenarios. It read like bad science fiction. For a while, I thought they were onto me, feeding me bogus information. But as time went on, with security tightening around the labs and no one confronting me, I began to suspect that my intel was legit. But time was running out, with Brezhnev and your President Nixon set to negotiate the nuclear disarmament treaty in a few weeks. My superiors were demanding results. My job on the line, I got desperate and careless. And this morning, I got caught. I was tailing an engineer into an off-limits lab when I bumped into Barney from security. Ironically, management chalked up my trespassing to cluelessness and settled for just firing me. Knowing I wouldn't get another chance, I stole a security badge and snuck back in. I just found the time machine operator's manual when you showed up out of nowhere and nearly screwed it all up. Then it clicked. Not only could I steal the technology, it was the perfect getaway, too. Using the manual, I set the destination as high as it would allow. I figured if I could just get far away, I'd have plenty of time to figure out how to get it back to the motherland. But, well, I guess you know the rest. Listen, Joe. I'm really sick, and I'm not making it back. But you still can. The time machine has a timer, like a toaster. It's designed to return home unless the timer's reset. I removed the main power supply fuse to keep it from taking off without me. Here, take it. I have no idea how you got here, and I guess it doesn't matter. Still, despite my mission, a double life, and the deceit, your friendship was always genuine. You're an honest guy, Joe. And I've really enjoyed your company. No, please leave me. The pain's coming back. Oh, it hurts to talk. Need rest.
Damn. That's the end of Frank, huh? That's... Oh no. You're contaminated. I just want to stand here for a screenshot. Cool. Let's use it for the time machine, I suppose. This time machine's far too long gone for that. I see. It looked fresher than the one we had inside. There's another time machine over there in the background. I just noticed it. Could probably use it with this. there and inserted the fuse. I just hope it still works. I wonder if there are multiple endings to this. What if he had tried to help Frank? I mean, he was a goner, but still. What happened? Did I pass out again? Whoa, the time machine. What happened to it? Fragile wall. Dead guard. There's a key on his belt. And there's a broken frame. Quarantine lockdown initiated. It's a broken part of the foreign organism detected. Looks like we can't get out. The door is locked. How do I get out? God, what's happening? I can feel my whole body getting stiff. Foreign organism? What's going on? What? What is happening right now? Maybe I should stay here and do the responsible thing.
Can't be. The foreign organism. It's me. I brought back the disease.
Yes.
I'm the one who spreads it. It was me all along. I must have brought it back with me. Oh God. I think I'm gonna throw up. I can't deal with this. What do I do?
Let's see here. I mean, the obvious solution is to put ourselves into a cryo chamber, but it would be stupid to not look for any other solution. And I'm guessing it's gonna be locked as well. Oh no. I suppose that's the only option left at this point. There's no keyhole. I think it's all controlled from that terminal. I need to get out of here. I don't have long before security arrives, and then I'm gonna infect everyone. Oh god, how do I get myself out of this? It's being controlled from the big terminal. Of course it is. Card reader door. Controls that use, but I don't know how to work it. Oh, wait, there's like cabinets and stuff inside. This guy can't even run though. File cabinet. Empty file folders, nothing I can use, probably something here. It's locked.
Oh,
it fits. Ow, what's happening to me? Just turning a key makes my muscles hurt. I can feel my arms and legs starting to go stiff. Lazarus Cryo Console Operator's Guide, 11th draft. I might be able to use this, but I've got to get away before security shows up and I start infecting everyone. I need to get a grip on all this. The virus kills mankind, Dr. Lambert finds me before it spreads in. But I get infected and spread the virus that kills mankind, so Dr. Lambert finds me before it spreads. Oh man. Wait, what? I guess we saved mankind by going to cryosleep back there. I mean, that's the only possible explanation right now. It's a piece of paper with some squiggly lines on it. A box of pens. Oh man, my joints are sore. Yeah, you've been sleeping for a long time. Doors are locked. It says IKEA next to the handle. There's no handle. Well, just give me a second there. Yeah, sorry about that. My dog started barking at somebody. There's a string here. Oh, that's just like in the hospital. Strange. I wouldn't be able to reach it with this, even if I made a paper airplane out of it. It looks like one of those polygraph test machines you've seen on cop shows. No, I'll hang on to this. Alright. There's a door here and a computer. Door, computer. What is this place? The last thing I remember is drowning? There was a tube. It's not locked. It's open. I should probably wait on taking action and read through the text before. I feel like I've been doing a bad job of that. It's a terminal of some kind, but nothing like one I've ever seen. Piece of paper, of course not. What am I doing? There's no way to put it. I guess the only option we have right now is to... I think I need to use the keypad, yes, but probably... There's no way I'd be able to guess the combination, exactly. This is... Hey, that's one of the people in the... That's the scientist.
Whoa there, man. No offense intended.
That dialogue was... So basically need the crutch. Man, that TV is really loud, but I can't reach it. I wonder why the TV is left so loud like that. We're being studied, aren't we? Because there's even like a camera in the... Okay, this guy is... There's even like a differential equation and everything here. There's the number 13 here. Jittery man.
No way to escape it. No way out, no way out, no way out.
I'm sorry, what?
End of days, scourge and sickness, the cleansing of the earth. The overlords conspired against us, tricked us, made us bring the poison back into the nest, like good little ants.
Who did?
Too late. What's done is done. No backseats, but we must try. Do you hear me?
Sure.
The key to salvation. I've seen it. Felt its color. Know its shape. They don't know that I know. Oh, no. But I know. I know. Write it. Write it, write it, write it. Before it disappears. Write it down before it disappears.
Took away my tools.
I'll forget without my tools.
Your tools?
Pens, paper. They're erasing the slate, forcing me to forget. Trying to break my resolve. The persistence of memory, I must repeat, repeat, repeat all the time, repeat. Oh, they fear me. Cower at the sight of scientific rigor. They know I'm close, so they take away my tools. I'll show them. The blinding light of the scientific method casts no shadows.
It's a desk lamp, but it's on the floor. Clearly this guy's not all there. It really brightens the room, though the disturbing writing on the walls makes me wish it didn't. Wait, this the number 3 and this is the number 13 in the... I'm not sure what that would do for me in either posing chair. There's some sort of gizmo stuck underneath the cushion. It kind of reminds me of those fancy Zenith Space Command TV remote controls. Only this one looks like it's actually from space. What's bothering me is this number 13 on the lamp, but I don't think we can interact with that such like that. Actually, let me just go ahead and investigate the picture frame nonetheless before I begin.
Damn.
I really thought this was better fastened. Butterfingers got a new achievement there. From the looks of this room, it would seem kind of pointless to try and put it back up again. But... Mark 3, me, fate unknown, 9999, 9000 cryogenic chambers. So yeah, it's basically talking about all the people there, you know, Sims and Hegel. All the people that were frozen in the cryo chambers, Lambert found dead, Janet arrested. Something obscured by the shadow of that man there. Amor Fati. Something in Greek. Test successful. Mark 1, 1968. 1983, fate unknown. That's Mark 2. Novus Ordo Seclorum. The Illuminati symbol there. What happened to Albus? Sims plus Hegel plus. That's the Freemason symbol there. The compass and the curved ruler on the right. There are also four eyes, but I don't know whether that actually says something. He's also trying to figure out what Archon could stand for. Perugia. I don't know how this differential equation solves to that, but alright, I'll take it on face value. I'm not interested in solving that all over again. Anyway, we have the remote. We can use that to turn the TV off in the next room. Let's see if this works. Hey, it worked! Whoa, hey guy, where are you going? Well, at least that took care of the noise. Yes, it did. Yes, it did. Got the crutch as well. I wonder why he had a crutch when he could just walk perfectly fine on his own. Do you really want to... You want to be agitated in pain, don't you? He's a lot calmer now, but still doesn't look like he's too fond of company. I'd better leave him alone. Alright, let's get the papers for him. Then. Sorry, the pens for him so that he can write something. Got it. I think most of the pens ended up on top of the closet, but at least I got one down. Got the pen.
Mightier than the sword. The pen.
Are you not going to write anything on the walls?
Need paper to reproduce the key. Need the paper. Gotta have paper.
You got the paper. Didn't you?
The key. The key. Keep it close. Keep it safe. Bring help! Don't get caught! Save the kingdom, get the girl! Save the kingdom, get the girl! Save the kingdom, get the girl!
I see, 5731. I feel like these people are just locked up for their own safety, but because we could have been inside one of these rooms as well. It works! I guess that crazy guy wasn't so crazy after all. Well, just because he's crazy doesn't mean he's wrong. A very common misconception there. One of these weird flat terminal screens again. Oh right, I forgot CRTs weren't even a thing back then. Oh shit.
Miss? Nurse?
Oh, hi there! Goodness, you startled me. You could have just knocked. And it's Doctor, actually, Dr. Emma Brown. I'm a little embarrassed to say, but we don't have any files on you, so I don't even know your name.
It's Joe, ma'am.
Oh, call me Emma. We're not so formal here. It's nice to meet you, Joe.
I'm sorry, Dr. Brown. I don't know how to say this, but you, everyone here, is in serious danger. I'm very sick, and it's very important you call the authorities and...
Whoa. Take it easy. Deep breaths. There's nothing to be afraid of. How do you feel?
Okay, I guess. A little sore.
See, you're fine. And the soreness is to be expected. You've undergone muscle therapy. You've been asleep for at least 3 decades, after all. Maybe even more.
Okay.
What?
At least.
Where am I? What year is this?
Easy, Joe. I know it's a lot to take in. It'd be a shock to anyone's system. Haven't been under for as long as you have. It's 2012, and this is the psychiatric ward at St. Genevieve's Hospital. You were brought out of hibernation 5 weeks ago. Like the others, you were placed in an artificial coma for regenerative muscle therapy and brought here for evaluation and rehab after everything checked out.
Oh, God. The tubes. You have to listen to me, Doctor. I'm dangerously sick. I was carrying something when I got in.
That? Well, that's true. You did all have some kind of flu. Actually, the resident physician did find it peculiar how you had all contracted a type of avian flu that only first appeared in the late 90s, and a new strain at that. In any case, the pathogen was largely dormant due to the extended hibernation. We run very thorough medical checks on all our cryo clients, so we gave you all a shot of our regular cocktail. Cleared it right up before you even came to.
So it's gone? But Archon...
Yes, I'm afraid I don't know much about all of that. All I know is that the company that froze you went bankrupt back in the early 70s. A victim of industrial sabotage, I think. Anywho, the remaining assets were sold off, and the Cryoform company bought the cryogenics technology. As per ethical requirements, that included all of you who were frozen there. We've been helping rehabilitate Cryoform's clients for the past 5 years or so. Mostly folks suffering from previously incurable terminal illnesses and heavy wallets. But you didn't hear that from me, hmm? Unfortunately, cryogenics was a little... experimental when you went under. So, while the company's been freezing and reviving clients for quite some time, you had to stay confined to the original equipment. Apparently, a lot of Archon's original documentation was destroyed in a fire. So Cryoform had practically no information on any of you. That's another reason it took so long to figure out how to revive you. Sadly, the others haven't been quite as coherent. They share certain delusions, you know, end of the world, that sort of thing. An unfortunate side effect of cryogenics' primitive state at the time, I suspect. You, however, seem just fine. Apart from the shock, I mean.
So I'm not sick? You sure?
Yes, Joe, quite sure. In fact, I see no reason to keep you here. We have an excellent rehabilitation team who'll get you settled into your new life in no time. Just come see me when you're ready to go.
A few ink-splattered pieces of paper. Looks like somebody had an accident with a leaky pen. Let's explore the cabinet there. I probably shouldn't try to open that. I'm not sure who that is, Colonel Sanders. This guy looks familiar. Oh, Sigmund Freud, right. Dr. Brown told me to come talk to her before leaving. I mean, I don't have anything else to do in there, right? Wait, I don't think I can operate a computer, can I? It's a terminal of some kind, but nothing like one I've ever seen before. Alright, let's talk to her then.
So? Are we all ready to go?
I guess.
Oh, don't worry. The rehab team's eager to help get you settled in. I know it may feel a little overwhelming now, but Trust me, you'll love it in 2012. Endless opportunities. A whole new lease on life.
Skyrocketing home rents.
Speaking of, I happened to catch you on the surveillance monitors a little while ago, and you seem to show excellent problem-solving skills.
Oh, thank you.
You like puzzles, Joe? Perfect. I'll be sure to mention it to the career coaches. They'll find just the right thing for you.
He's slowly updated with the times, isn't he? Working at what seems to be a call center. Customer support. Just heading through life for the most part. I guess for him it's life back to normal, I suppose. And that was that for the Silent Age. I mean, the game was just as charming and suspenseful as the first time around that I played it, and the fact that I didn't remember any of the story sort of makes it even more special. It was this one game and another game that I liked. It was, I think it was called Father and Son, but I'm not sure. It was, as the title suggests, a journey about a son and his father, and it was more about a journey through time, about this guy rediscovering his father's influence, and yeah, another point and click puzzle sort of adventure, which again I really liked. So anyhow, as for the Silent Age, this is it. Towards the end, stuff got a little obtuse, the solutions to the puzzles got a little obtuse, but for the most part it was pretty intuitive all in all. And I mean, the time travel mechanic they've integrated it into the gameplay mechanics very well, helping it sort of connect a lot of the puzzle pieces together. But after a certain point, it just sort of becomes annoying when you have to keep switching through, you know, switching between the future and the present, just so that you can access a certain part of the level. It's like you have to switch through the past and switch between the present and the future in for every other scene, or maybe in the same scene itself, and that sort of becomes annoying after a point. So I would say that they might have overdone it a little there, but yeah, I mean, that's the only negative downside of this game that I could find. The rest of it is pretty amazing. The storyline is amazing. It has a sense of suspense right through until the end, and the ending, if you did not see it, you know, coming, would essentially, can pretty much shock you. A pretty nice twist ending there, and a short credit sequence as well. So that's another thing that's amazing about this game. But yeah, total, all in all, a pretty solid game, I would say. The Silent Age. And that was it for The Silent Age, honestly, the entire playthrough. So thank you for watching, thank you for tuning in, thank you for sticking around until the end of not just this video, but this entire playlist, this entire series, this entire playthrough. I think I'm going to try playing another point-and-click puzzle adventure after this. Pink Panther in Hocus Pocus Pink is what I'm thinking about. I played it as a child quite extensively, but I don't think I'll be able to solve any of the puzzles right now. And again, it has a lot of that cartoon logic, so let's see how it goes. Anyhow, this was it for the Silent Age. A pretty brilliant, a pretty short game, but definitely one worth playing. So, yeah. See you guys next time. Take care. Fare thee well, fellow orphans.